Okay, my name is Enrique Ocio. I'm from the University Hospital, Marqués de Valdecilla in Santander, in Spain. And I have presented here in the AS 2018 meeting the preliminary data results of the phase one study of isatuximab in combination with VRd for elderly newly diagnosed multiple myeloma patients. This was a phase one trial that initially was designed for the combination of isatuximab and BCD, but based on the good results of a SWOG study, we decided to amend this trial to include a cohort of patients treated with this isatuximab plus bortezomib, lenalidomide, and dexamethasone. So 27 patients with newly diagnosed multiple myeloma that were not candidates to autologous stem cell transplantation were treated with this combination. The median age was 71, and they were most of them ISS 1 and 2, and with 13% of the patients had high-risk cytogenetic abnormalities. I think in terms of overall response, I think this is the most compelling data of the trial. All patients responded. And at the time of the cutoff point, 92% of patients achieved VGPR or better, that now currently we have converted to 100%. So all patients have achieved a VGPR, at least VGPR. We have a response rate, a CR rate of 19%, but this may be underestimated because we don't have in this trial an interference assay for the monoclonal antibody. So many of these patients, in fact, 60% of the patients were IgG kappa. So many of these IgG kappa patients may have a CR, but we are not able to detect it. So in terms also of MRD, we have the opportunity to perform MRD testing in these patients. We have done it now in 16 patients by NGS and NGF. And there was quite good correlation between both techniques, but at least 7 patients were MRD negative by both techniques, 7 out of the 16. That brings 44% of patients achieving MRD negativity. So I think these are quite compelling data in terms of response for these newly diagnosed myeloma patients, eligible for transplantation. Regarding toxicity, treatment was quite well tolerated. We have a high rate of peripheral neuropathy, 70% of them, but most of it, or the great majority of it, was grades 1 and 2, so it was good. And we had also 63% of infusion-related reactions. This could be a bit high, but we have to say that the infusion duration was low, 3.7 hours, yes, for the first infusion, and 2.7 hours, so it was quite short for subsequent infusions for isatuximab. From these 63% of patients, most of the reactions were in the first cycle, in first infusion, and only one patient had an infusion reaction after the first infusion. And they were quite mild also in grades 1-2, only one of them, or the patients had a grade 3 infusion-related reaction, and this was discontinued from the trial because of that. Regarding other adverse events, we have some pneumonias, and only one patient died due to a bacteriemia. But well, this is quite consistent with previous data on this patient population. So in summary, I think this is isatuximab bortezomib blendex. It's a good combination with a very high response rate, VGPR rate of 100% at the present time. And we think we have a high number of patients in CR, and we know that 44% of them are at least in MRD negative state.